Hello, hello. Welcome, everybody. How are you? Hello, hello. Welcome back. How are you guys? Hello, Patricia. Good evening. How are you?
Hello, teacher. Good evening. I'm fine.
How are you today?
I'm very, very relaxed.
Very good.
That this day is my vacation.
Oh, it's your day off.
Yeah.
Cool. Are you ready for your English class?
Yes.
Excellent. Let's get started. Okay. What information do you remember about the previous class?
The method we tell and ask.
The what? Repeat.
The method we tell and ask.
That is correct. That's what we were looking at yesterday. So today we're going to do a little review. We were looking at, can I take a message? Talking about the video. We're going to watch the video one more time. Please listen.
Okay.
Yes, please. This is Mr. Kale.
Is that G-A-L-E?
No, it's K-A-L-E.
All right.
Please tell her our meeting is on Friday at 2:30.
Friday at 2:30.
And could you ask her to call me this afternoon? My number is 646-555-4031.
646-555-4031. Yes, Mr. Kale. I'll give Ms. Graham the message.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
At this moment, do you have any questions referring to this vocabulary?
No.
No? All right. We're going to continue with the next activity. For the next activity, we're going to be looking at section 5.7. By the end of the session, you will be able to take and give a message using tell and ask. Al final de esta clase, usted será capaz de tomar y dar un mensaje usando los verbos decir y pedir. Listen, please.
Let's continue, shall we? Now let's go over on how to take and give a phone message using the verbs tell and ask. Get your papers ready and take notes during the explanation.
Page 103, Exercise 8, Grammar Focus. Messages with tell and ask. Statement.
The meeting is on Friday.
Messages with a statement.
Please tell Anne the meeting is on Friday. Please tell Anne that the meeting is on Friday. Could you tell her the meeting is on Friday? Could you tell her that the meeting is on Friday? Would you tell her the meeting is on Friday? Would you tell her that the meeting is on Friday?
Request.
Call me this afternoon.
Messages with a request.
Please ask him to call me this afternoon. Could you ask him to call me this afternoon? Would you ask him to call me this afternoon?
When leaving a message, we may state the information or request something. The way to do it when we leave a message with a statement is as follows. When leaving a message, we may state the information or request something. The way to do it when we leave a message with a statement is as follows. Tell plus person plus that plus the statement. And because we want to be polite, we may add please, could you, or would you. Notice that is in brackets because it may be omitted. When leaving a message with a request, this is how we should do it. Ask plus person plus to plus the request. Again, we use please, could you, or would you to be polite. Ready? This is the statement I want you to work with. Our next class is on Friday. please write three possible statement messages as shown on the chart. And this is the request. Meet me this afternoon. Again, please write three possible request messages on our discussion box.
All right. Did you do this activity yesterday? ¿Terminó la actividad ayer?
Yes.
Did you write it here on the discussion forum?
Yes.
All right.
Yes,
Patricia.
Yes.
Here you are. Messages with statements. Please tell the teacher that tomorrow I will not be able to go to class. Could you tell the teacher that tomorrow? Excellent. Okay, so now we're going to be looking at the knowledge check. The knowledge check is coming from 5.9 instructions. Look at the following message, slips. Write down the entire message using the words in parentheses. Remember to use proper punctuation. Instrucciones. Escriba un mensaje completo usando las palabras en paréntesis. Recuerde de usar la puntuación necesaria. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready. But could you give me the first one sentence, please?
Yes. The first one you can say?
Only one example.
Could you tell me? Look at the following message slips. Write down the entire message using the words in parentheses. So here, could you tell me would be the correct idea. Qué complicada está esta. Esta sí está complicada. Okay, I think that we're going to do this one together. So, for example, the first one says, could you tell me or could you tell Joel the movie is at 7. Mm-hmm. And number two, would you ask Mitch, would you ask Mitch to pick me up at home around 4. Number 3. Please tell Eva the concert on Saturday is canceled. Number 4, would you ask Jim to bring the tickets for the
hockey game tonight. And the last one, five. Would you tell Anne the museum open at 10 tomorrow morning? And six is, please ask Jerry to meet us in front of the cafeteria at 12:15. But please ask Jerry to meet us in front of the cafeteria at 12:15. So to get a point. Qué raro.
¿A usted se la marcó correcta o incorrecta?
No, incorrect.
¿Ah?
Incorrect. Incorrecta.
Ah, quitémosle el puntito al final.
Okay.
Y a esta le vamos a quitar el símbolo de pregunta. Igual da mal. So yeah, would you ask Jim to bring the tickets for the hockey game? Aquí está el error, ve. T-O-N-I-G-H-T. Ahí está. Le puse una N de más, pero igual me sale mal. Voy a ponerle N. Tonight, le ponemos el símbolo de pregunta. Ahora sí. Ahora sí. Ahora sí. Ok. ¿Ya las terminaste?
Only the number five and number one.
Okay, number five. ¿Qué le has puesto para number five?
Would you tell the machine at 10 tomorrow?
Okay, number five sería, would you tell Anne the museum opens at 10 tomorrow morning?
Y el símbolo de pregunta al final.
You got it?
Yes, I got it.
Okay. And what about number six?
Number six, I think.
It's okay.
Yes.
Okay. Let's continue. We're going to look at section 5.10, lesson objective, reading exercise. This reading exercise will help you develop skills in summarizing and recognizing point of view. Este ejercicio de lectura le ayudará a desarrollar habilidades para resumir y reconocer puntos de vista. Cell phone etiquette. Estamos leyendo sobre etiqueta del teléfono. So, lo que vamos a hacer aquí es que va a leer el artículo y después va a contestar las frases que el escritor pudiera estar de acuerdo con ellas, dependiendo de lo que dice la lectura. Tiene 10 minutos, 10 minutes.
Okay.
Action.
Are you finished? Hello, Patricia, are you finished?
Yes, I'm finished.
You're done?
Yes.
Do you have any questions at this moment?
I think probably.
Number two, cell phone users are very rude people.
Number three, the turn off your cell phone is not as you.
Okay. That's correct.
Because respect the rules of restaurant. Turn off the cell phone.
Oh, okay. So we're gonna click on 3, 6, 7, and 8. Got it?
Okay. Got it.
Now, what we're going to be moving on to is the final exam. You can start doing your final exam, and then we can check it. Are you ready?
Okay.
You may begin. Listen to a conversation. Listen to two telephone conversations. Check the correct information. You have 10 minutes. 10 minutes. And then we will check together.
Okay.
Are you finished with that section?
I finished it.
All right. What do you have for number one?
Number one is a beach party.
Beach party. Number two?
Number two, the two start work at 6 p.m.
He starts work at 6 p.m. Rita?
Dance performance.
Dance performance. Rita again.
And she needs to study for the test.
She needs to study for the test. Excellent work. Very good. Now, what we're going to be doing is moving on to the next section, which is coming from the exam. The same part, which is put the words in the correct order. So in this activity, we're going to look at the conversations and complete the words. For example, what do you plan do tonight? So the answer would be, what do you plan to do tonight? I would like for you to do the rest. You have 10 minutes. Hello, Patricia, are you finished? Hello, hello.
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher, I finished.
Okay, let's do letter B.
Yeah. Okay. I want to say, there are so very much on TV.
Excellent. Number two.
What are you and Dave going to do tomorrow?
Tomorrow, right. B?
We would like to have a barbecue on the beach.
We would.
May rain.
A barbecue on the beach, but it may rain. Three?
What do you have to do after graduation?
All right.
I would love to travel in Europe for a while.
Okay. All right. So we're going to stop right here. I would like for you to continue finishing your exam. Puede completar el resto del examen en su tiempo.
Okay.
All right, and have a good night, and we see you tomorrow.
Okay, goodbye to you tomorrow, teacher.
See you, Patricia. Bye-bye. Thank you.